let's film this.
I really don't need to prove anything to anyone, but I just wanted to do this video because I do get the occasional comment once in a while that's just like, she's fake, she has Botox. And I just wanted to make this video because I hate the way that Botox looks. I would never in a million years get Botox injected in my face. I think it looks terrible, but I got this when I did mewing, and I got this when I did subliminal stuff, and people were like, you got Botox. I have no Botox. I have no Botox in my jaw. I have no Botox, so I'm just gonna show you facial expressions so you know that I don't have Botox. And I want to show you I have wrinkles, like, you know, I have small, like, fine lines in my face. I don't have Botox. I have fine lines. I have fine lines here. I have fine lines and wrinkles in my forehead, and that's fine. That is indication that I am a person who has lived on this planet. That's fine. Basically, I have no Botox, none in my face, nothing. This is literally my face. I have a bone right here. It is a solid ass bone. It's not a filler. And that's why I have high cheekbones. I have a jaw, you know, that I do mewing, which is tongue posture. And that is how I got my jaw to, like, to go outward when I used to have no jaw here at all. I did that because I didn't want to do anything with filler, but I liked the way that a model's face structure looked. And I was trying to, you know, get more of, like, a face, better face structure. So if I go like this, I got wrinkles everywhere. So no Botox, none like that at all. If I go like this, I've got, you know, wrinkles right there. You know, my face moves. This is such a crazy video. Go like that. My face. Wrinkled up. And you might say, oh, the Botox wore off. Well, no, because I have, like, literally, like, wrinkles on my face. You know, I have small wrinkles on my face, so I never got Botox. It didn't have a chance to wear off. I could do this video once a month if people need this to know that I'm not getting Botox. It's not wearing off or anything. I have no Botox. This is my nose. No surgery on my nose. Okay, I'm sick of it. It's annoying, but, you know, I let people think what they want. You can either choose to believe in mewing and subliminals that I did. I no longer do them though, and at the end of the day, that's up to you. So yeah, Chile. I do not have the money to go get plastic surgery. I am not rich, and I just don't have that type of money to do that. Secondly, I dislike the way it looks so much. I understand that my appearance has changed over the years. As people grow up, their appearance changes. I've used subliminals. I've also done mewing, which changes you a lot, but at the same time, I look a lot like I used to look. It's not like I'm a completely different person. You know, people aren't, like, coming up to me from high school being like, who are you? Like, they still recognize me. So, you know, there's possible to do slight changes and stuff to your appearance, but you're not going to get, like, an entire facelift from mewing or subliminals, nor should you want to. Okay, so just please stop. And if you're on this channel and you want to do mewing and you already got fillers in your jaw, it doesn't actually help as much to change your jaw structure when there's already filler in your jaw. So I'd recommend getting that stuff dissolved before you ever did mewing or anything like that, because it will just keep it so stiff that you won't be able to get results from mewing if you got fillers. I'm no way shaming people who have gotten Botox. I'm in no way shaming them or telling them that that is, you know, a bad decision or that they look bad, but that is just my personal opinion. It's a very strong opinion. You can seriously do so much to stop that Botox. You don't need to keep putting that in your face, okay? And if you're on this channel, there's a reason you're on this channel, and you're on this channel to understand more about your body and keeping your spirit healthy and doing all of that. And with plastic surgery, I just see it as a very antiquated way of doing something that I think our consciousness can naturally do. And, you know, I feel the same way with certain, like, high-end makeup brands that are very, like, expensive and, you know, have a lot of chemicals and toxins in them. I try to stay away from that. So things like that, just try to do it the natural way, and it'll be a lot better for you in the future, and for so many people in the future. It's so much better of an option. And yeah, it's not a cool thing to do anymore. Botox, we gotta stop, you know, making it a cool thing. Let's phase this stuff out, guys, because it's so antiquated, and we don't need these poisons in our skin. We don't need the side effects from surgery. A lot of people die from plastic surgery, going under the knife, of course. There was just that recent Instagram model, rest in peace to her. And it's so sad because, you know, people have so much life ahead of them, but, you know, surgery is just so risky, so freaking risky. And just you don't get to put yourself in those situations, guys. Love yourself. If you have an issue, insecurity, you know, there are ways around that, and there are ways to go about that that don't involve Botoxicillin and all these names. What's it called? I probably didn't say it right, but just, you know, the name of it. And just why at the end of the day do you have to put something inside of yourself that's unnatural and that's also gonna slow down your reaction system? And we all like use our emotions and our face to communicate, so like seeing a stiff, unnatural face is like so like jarring to just like interact with. And for some reason, like on TikTok and just on social media these days, it has become the norm to see a very stiff, unmoving face, and like it's just become like okay, like it's so normalized. And like there used to be like a stigma, I guess, but like now isn't much of a stigma. People are just choosing their own like superficial needs over like their health and over the deeper things in them, which is unfortunate. And I want to raise awareness about that on my channel. I don't want to, you know, have these debates where it's like, oh, did I get a surgery? Like, no, I understand I got very amazing mewing and sub results and things like that, but at the end of the day, like, I don't need to like keep proving that to people. I don't need to keep like, you know, sitting here being like this and that. Like, you can either choose to believe me or not. Like, I really just don't care at this point. I know like haters are gonna watch this video and they're gonna be like, oh my god, you're lying. And like, I really just don't care at this point. That's so ranty. You should look into facial exercises. Do like puffing up your cheek. You can, you know, massage your face like that, and that helps. You can also just use retinol and vitamin A. It really helps to keep your face looking younger and fresh. I would never recommend Botox either, because it's a toxin, and injecting a toxin into my face would be completely against everything I've ever done to detox of toxins for like years, and I just would never do that. Toxin, and eventually I think your facial muscles just like atrophy from that Botox. So just a no. And also, sometimes I use a filter on Instagram that makes it look like I have like huge lips and a smaller nose. That's just an Instagram filter, so chile, okay? And stop, you know, saying that. And you know, at the end of the day, it's fine. I don't really care. I just thought, you know, why not do a quick little video for you guys anyway. All right, so I'll talk to you guys later. So here is some fun with my facial wrinkles, and you can see that I don't have any Botox in my face at all. If you want to stay tuned for more content, I have an amazing second channel about my new dwarf bunny rabbits called Sugar Bunnies, and you guys can go over there and subscribe for content about these little angels going to eat apples and sitting in cups and looking super, super cute like the newborn baby bunnies that they are. And I hope you guys could subscribe and support my second channel, and you will not regret it, because these are just the cutest, fluffiest little angels that I have ever seen, and I love them very much. So go over there and subscribe, like, and share the videos.